Hey guys, it's Xavier Kelly. In today's video, I'm gonna walk you through how to structure your Google Ads account the same way I do it so you can get more conversions. Make sure you stay tuned to learn more about it. Thank you guys so much for making it to this video right now. We're about to get straight into this video. So if you haven't already, make sure you go ahead and subscribe down below. I would love to see you guys joining the family and really just see more videos and see what stuff we have coming out. We have some lots of cool things more coming out each week. We have a podcast series that we're doing with some really cool people in the marketing and online business industry and people who are started their business, entrepreneurs. I want you guys to stay tuned and look forward to. That's something we're coming out with too as well. But right now, let's get straight into the video. Number one, you need to set your campaign settings. There's a couple things we want to do when we have our campaign set up. Basically, we're going to walk through this video, we're going to walk through a couple, like three to four of them that will really help you out. First thing, you need to ensure that your campaigns are running in the location that you want them to. And what I mean by this right here is that if you go to Google AdWords, or Google Ads now, in 2018, you go to Google Ads, you want to make sure you go, when you go to location setting, go to your settings, make sure your location settings is for people who are actually in your location and not searching about your location. Because then you have the issue where you'll be paying, I have a client one time who was paying $3,000 extra for people that's not even in the area, and they only sold to a local community of 20 mile radius, yes, but they were showing ads to people who were 5,000 miles away because those people were not in their area. So make sure you're only running ads to the people that are in your specific area. And also too as well, even if you're running something that sells to multiple different countries or multiple different regions, make sure you group those regions in separate campaigns so you can be able to tailor to work with those individually campaigns in those individual industries. And just so the location doesn't get mashed together in the wording and how you change it, you might see that if you're doing something in New York, you're doing something in Dallas. The wording in Dallas for certain things you do might not sell to people in New York. People stuff you do in New York might not sell to people in Dallas. You don't want to have that issue. So separate your campaigns based off of regions the best you possibly can, but try not to go too far in depth and have too many campaigns. Number two, and this is something that Google wants to kind of get you on a little bit so they can make a little extra money, is that when you first go to actually set up your campaign, make sure you go ahead and just deselect the search partners and deselect the display network. These area, if not used properly and using for not what you want to, you will waste a lot of money and a lot of time using. So I recommend you not use those areas and try to use other different things to make it actually better. So one thing I would do is first, as soon as you come in there, only use search. Do not use display and do not use search partners. This right here will save you so much time and effort. And the reason why you want to do that right there for is because if you're running a keywords campaign that's searching for certain people over certain keyword using SEM, then you don't want to be running ads over something along the lines of, you know, something online, someone's website that has nothing to do with what you're doing. And you really need to, when you do display, it needs to be a separate campaign, something totally different, and you need to just work on just getting people search with the intent of purchasing something. Number three, make sure you set up a schedule for your ads. So this is literally the most important thing besides the other two that will help you get more conversions and manage your money a lot better. If you're selling to B2B, then you shouldn't be running ads at the middle of the night. And you shouldn't, and sometimes you might not even run ads over the weekends, and that's something you can test out. So I really recommend, if you're running ads, sell it when your people actually could be searching for. So if no one searches for stuff in the morning, then put all your effort and time into getting those people to come back and pay for those people to come in the evening. Don't pay for stuff when people are not searching, or people that are in your business are searching for it. Specifically B2B, and when you are working with different people on the lines of who are, you know, bigger companies, a lot of bigger companies will not be searching for different business related stuff on the weekends because those people are not working. Those businesses are not open. So make sure as much as possible that you are scheduling your ads out appropriately. And this also means too, if you are in the United States and you're running ads in the UK, make sure those ads are split up and set up for exactly those specific geography time zones and times so that it runs specifically over there at the same times. So it's not running in the middle of the night over there and you're losing all the traffic and all of the clicks and leads from over there or sales that you're doing if you're running ads in the UK. So make sure you are not doing that. Number four, this is something right here that a lot of people fall in trouble with. It's pretty simple. If you do not create a campaign that is specifically for a mobile users, then you should not be advertising to mobile, to people who are using mobile. And this, even if your site is mobile friendly, there's a certain way you set up your mobile experience to actually run ads to, and some people do not actually go through and fill out as much information on their mobile phone. So one thing you really should go through and do is have something set up for mobile campaigns and something set up for your desktop users, and tablet users can be a little bit of both in that portion. But one thing you really want to do when you're going through and doing this is set up your bid adjustments per device. So for me, when I'm running my B2B leads, most of my people who are searching for software, the purchase software that I sell with my company that I work for, is going to be more older people too as well, who are using their laptops, their computers. So I do not run ads on people on their mobile phones or their tablets. Now you might think, Xavier, you are losing conversion. My ads are specifically made for people who are on their laptops. When I do create a campaign for someone to use mobile, it will only be for mobile users. So basically right now I have most of my campaigns, you go into it, the desktop is going to be basically exactly what is that right now. And then the tablet, sometimes I use leave tablets on, depends on how I design the page, but tablet and mobile phones are at -100. So when I'm bidding across those, I am not bidding any money across those users to be able to acquire any of the clicks from them. So you will miss out a little bit, but you will save more money and you will have higher qualified leads because you are creating specifically for the platform. Now I'm not saying don't ever create mobile campaigns. I'm saying that you should have a campaign that is specifically for your desktop user and specifically for your mobile users. And also too, this is what has worked best for me. There is some people who can do both and have mobile responsive sites that look well and design and can manipulate and look good for both these places. But you have to plan these out. Even if you run one campaign over it, you need to be going ahead and creating your website and your landing page for your mobile users to be a lot more mobile friendly and to be a lot likely for people to actually click on and use your user forms or use one of your sell features, so they work a lot better. So this can be, adding less text. This can be something on the lines of getting to the point a little faster. This can be making bigger buttons, removing sections. So you can't just stack everything on top of each other and hope that, it comes out pretty good. So that's one thing I would say about that right there. But guys, I want to talk to you about this new venture. I'm going to call it a venture, but it's really just a new podcast, kind of video podcast that I'm really looking forward to. Been reaching out, talking to a lot of interesting entrepreneurs and digital marketers in the DFW area, and I really want to share their stories and help you guys learn a little more about different things, and specific people where you have these specialists who have been working in the field for a long period of time and perfecting their crafts. And I want to be able to share that. I'm going to share that in this new podcast that I'm coming up with. I don't have exactly yet the naming structure of it yet, but when I do have it, I'll put it up and I'll let you guys know and everything on that part. But it's something else I want to add more to the channel, just to give you guys a more deeper insight into, of ways you guys can actually grow your skill sets and actually be able to develop your businesses and work a little bit harder on different things, different topics. That I have done before, but that people were actually better than me. A lot of these topics, a lot of these people will be actually pretty good at what they do and help to put, just a good way to go about it. So that's one thing we're going to look into doing. Also, too, I'm going to start back up my Patreon accounts. And basically, Patreon accounts going to be for account reviews. This can be over your AdWords account. This can be your Taboola Outbrand account or over your Instagram account. Because we got a lot of cool stuff on that part, too, as well. And looking over your actual website to help you fix things. Be a 30-minute consultation and actually figuring out fixing certain bugs that we're going to help you guys with. But guys, remember, guys, I'm Xavier Kelly. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Comment down below and tell me, guys, different ways you guys are using to be able to make your account a little bit better, and what stuff you do on every single ad campaign that you create on Google Ads. So I would love to hear from you. And also, guys, subscribe and share this with someone in need. And guys, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.